Hello, my name is Jorge Varela Barreras, and I am going to show you how advanced battery models can enable the development of simple but effective derating strategies in the context of standalone mini-grids. This work is based on the research conducted by Jake for his master's thesis under the supervision of Sheridan and myself. There have also been other researchers involved, including Michael, who provided the battery degradation model, Billy, Kiara, and Jenny. Results shown here have been presented before in ECS Prime and will be published soon in a journal article. The United Nations Sustainable Development Goal 7 is about ensuring universal energy access. 840 million people today do not have access to electricity, but it is expected that 25% of them will get access through mini-grids by 2030. For around 40% of that people, the most cost-effective solution will be to implement an isolated mini-grid with solar photovoltaics. But battery costs are still a particular problem for widespread adoption, and so durability and reliability issues. The problem is that battery performance and degradation is really complex and still poorly understood by many grids practitioners. This leads to unclear battery selection and system operational decisions. In this context, our work study how to improve simple battery operational strategies in order to extend battery lifetime. Our methodology to develop and evaluate the impact of different operational strategies has four basic pillars: a techno-economic optimization framework, the battery degradation models, the real-world case study data, and the battery operational strategies. The optimization framework is called Rover, and it is an open source tool developed in-house. The real world case study data is used as an input in the optimization framework, which in turn is used to determine the optimal sizing of the mini grid. The resulting battery profile is used as an input for the advanced degradation model, considering the impact of different operational strategies. Finally, all the techno-economic variables are re-evaluated and compared. We have used in the simulations real-world load data can be provided by Mess Power Rwanda. These load data are combined with temperature and insulation data for two locations, in Rwanda and in India, obtained from Renewables Ninja, a web tool developed by Imperial College and ETH Zurich. The location in Rwanda has a tropical savanna climate, and the one in India a humid subtropical climate, which means more spring temperatures. The same load data was used for both locations to be able to evaluate the impact of the climatic conditions in isolation. Using Clover, the cost optimal PV and battery sizing was determined. In a nutshell, Clover finds the battery capacity and PV peak power that minimize the levelized cost of used energy, considering that only a limited amount of blackouts are allowed. These are the resulting specifications obtained by Clover. And this figure shows the electricity demand of the mini grid alongside the simulated energy flows. The battery is charged during central hours of the day, storing the excess in PV production, and it is discharged during the rest of the day. Maximum C rates are very low. State of health is used as figure of merit in battery degradation. SOH can be defined in terms of capacity fade and or internal resistance increase depending on the application. In the context of islanded mini-grids, where currents are low and energy stored is the bottleneck, SOH is defined in terms of capacity fed. In this study, two degradation models to predict SOH are used. The models are parameterized for a lithium iron phosphate 26650 cell manufactured by Sony. The more simple energy throughput linear degradation model is the one integrated in Clover. This model assumes that capacity declines linearly with cumulative energy supplied by the battery. It is parameterized using dataset information. On the other hand, we use a more sophisticated nonlinear semi-empirical model coupled with an electrothermal performance model to obtain new insights. This model is parameterized using experimental data and was validated in previous publications. The model calculates calendar and cycle aging separately and relates capacity loss with battery temperature, state of charge, capacity throughput, and charge current. We explore several scenarios, considering the two degradation models, the two locations, and three different operational strategies: node derating, and state of charge or temperature-based derating. In the latter cases, the battery charge and discharge requested current is limited depending either on the battery temperature or the battery state of charge, following really simple relationships as shown in these exemplary figures. In this other figure, we compare the predicted capacity fade by the two models under no derating conditions. The Clover's simple linear degradation model is inaccurate, underestimating capacity fade at the beginning and overestimated later on. This might lead to battery oversizing. On the other hand, the more sophisticated model shows that climate can impact lifetime significantly, even in more than 4 years, being shorter in the humid subtropical climate due to extreme temperatures. This bar plot compares the impact of the different operational strategies over a 20-year simulation period. 80 to 90% of capacity fade is related with calendar aging mechanisms, which makes sense considering the low system currents. State of charge based derating was proven effective to reduce calendar aging without affecting system reliability in all climates. As shown in the box, battery lifetime was extended by 5 to 7 years. On the other hand, temperature based derating was able to reduce calendar aging only under extreme climates, by reducing self-heating effects, but also reducing reliability of the system, that is, increasing blackouts and the met energy fraction. Therefore, it's not recommended. So, these are the key take-home messages. Advanced degradation models are key for optimal sizing considering climatic conditions. Degradation in mini-grids is mainly due to calendar aging, being faster in extreme climates. Calendar aging rate is controllable with simple state-of-charge-based derating algorithms, achieving around 45% of battery lifetime extension. And temperature-based derating is only useful under extreme climates, but may reduce system reliability. This research has revealed the hidden potential of simple operational strategies, which should be really attractive for industry, since they are low cost and easy to implement, do not have additional hardware or software requirements, can be retrofitted, and are intrinsically robust and stable. Interestingly, these algorithms have been unexplored so far, but we prove that they can increase battery lifetime by almost one half. And that's all for today. Thank you very much for your kind attention.